I'm about to pass over the top, so we'll get a better look.
When you're flying a fighter jet, you need to be confident in your own abilities.
But sometimes I feel like I'm an idiot, I'm an imposter.
And monster, see mortar fire, point of impact.
I'm eyes on.
You can't help but start to think, am I made for this? Because
to take a life, you have to be 100% sure in what you're doing. There can't be any doubts.
The RAF is on high alert.
The world at the moment is not in the best of places.
The Russian vessel running along at 10 knots.
Everything that's happening with Russia and Ukraine, it's like a tinderbox.
You're doing an important role protecting from Vladdy the Baddy.
Go, boys!
With conflict in Europe and the Middle East.
Maintain eyes on that person.
British warplanes are poised to face any threat.
Russian markings. Bogey continues to track north.
We are one trigger press away from starting World War III.
Follow me.
Speed low, recover.
And when you've sat in your MP for about 2 hours over Mosul, have you really made it? It's what you don't see on top gun.
Can you get your hands out of your pockets, please? You know, if you've got cold hands, that's why we ask you your gloves. You know what I'm going to say, don't you? The cleaners haven't picked all that up this morning. That's the boys and girls that have chucked that in there last night. Morning, morning, Rob. How are you, mate? You OK? Oh, living the dream. Thanks, pal.
My name's Warrant Officer Rob Moylan. I am the Station Warrant Officer here at RAF Lossiemouth.
What gets my back up is people that are disrespectful. That and seagulls. Get my back up as well, but you know what I mean? When you're at Lossiemouth, that's par for the course.
The station warrant officer, known as the SWO, is responsible for RAF discipline across the whole of Lossiemouth Air Base.
So when I was junior rank, there was always a degree of apprehension when you saw the SWO coming. More often than not, you'd try and turn around or find a side alley to get down before you actually got collared by them. Things aren't too dissimilar now, especially when we're walking down a long drag like this. You can normally see people coming, and if they see you, they'll probably try and take an alternative route, but get off my garden! Gents, have you got your IDs on you?
The Station Warrant Officer role is to be the exemplar.
Happy days, thank you.
For service discipline.
Okay, you've got a lanyard there. You stick it around your neck, please.
You set the standard.
This is the combined mess, so this is one of the high footfall areas. We've got Costa Coffee, Subway and the like in here. But it's heavily used by personnel from across the station. When you're on a main operating base like RAF Lossiemouth, we need to know who everybody is at all times. ID's imperative, so that's why we wear them on display. Where's your ID at? So, right. So that's not acceptable, is it? You know what I mean? RAF police are the main people on this station to deal with security. You're not cutting around with your ID on. All right? Need to nail that. All right? Just remember it's on a lanyard, goes around your neck for a reason. All right? Jesus.
Accepting lower standards in certain areas that may not be viewed as important. It might be dress, it might be discipline. Is that then going to migrate into lower standards in engineering, in how we operate our platforms on our safety critical functions that could result in a failure to deliver on operations.
It might seem like now, well, we're just chilling out, but we're always on standby. You never know what could happen. We're always on our toes.
Lossy departures, Jedi 11 flight 4.
I don't even know what else we've got to do.
Craig, it's Colin upstairs. Could somebody come up and look at a radar clutter, please?
Beat us to it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Always ready, because, like I said, it could go from nothing to everything. Where's Lewis with these brews, eh?
Am I lifting you up?
Yeah, go on.
I thought it was a bit heavy.
From mechanical engineers to armourers.
Can you just pull it?
Watch that cable doesn't pull out, though.
Every year, key Lossiemouth personnel must deploy for up to 6 months on overseas operations.
Do you want a hand getting your bags?
Yeah, cheers, mate.
200 members of one squadron, including Typhoon pilot Ben Chergi, are heading to the Mediterranean to support the ongoing battle against Islamic State in Syria and Iraq.
Do you think everything you've done airborne would have prepared you for anything you could see?
I don't think you can ever be fully prepared. Yeah, I don't think you can ever replicate those stress levels and that fear. I think you've just got to go out there and do it.
Yeah.
Which is what I'm looking forward to, finally getting out there. See you in 4 months.
I'll catch you soon.
Sounds good, mate.
See you a bit. So this is the first time I'm going to be flying over Badlands, if you will. Which, you know, I'll be lying if I say I wasn't slightly nervous.
Known as Chergs, this is his first operational deployment after 7 years of training.
Those voices in your head are, you know, constantly questioning. You can't help but start to think, am I made for this? Am I good enough?
Although defeated territorially in 2019, Islamic State fighters remain in Iraq and Syria. Operation Shader is a coalition mission working with local and international forces to eliminate the remnants of the terror group.
All right, so the mission today is operating in the eastern side of Syria, western part of Iraq, and counter ISIS operations. You're on the front line, so the pressure's definitely there.
Chirk's first mission at RAF Akrotiri is to fly 600 miles east into Syria, where coalition forces and innocent civilians have been targeted by a spate of mortar attacks.
The primary risk we're going to be looking at today is any sort of surface threat, ISIS activity, and just reacting to any intelligence that we've received throughout the mission.
You know, not getting excited is kind of the key to that, because if everyone starts shouting, it just spirals, and at the end of the day, people start dying.
When you walk towards an aircraft and it's fully armed with bombs and missiles, it definitely focuses the mind. This isn't training. This isn't the time to make a mistake. To take a life, you have to be 100% sure in what you're doing. There can't be any doubts. That's what I want to get right, and that's what keeps me awake at night.
Monster, come up 24 in the back, just to listen up.
Bam-Bam, Monster 1-2.
Monster 1-2, Bam-Bam, hello. We are still at 260 in MOM.
Copy, 260 at MOM, I joined 250.
Don't cut the corner.
Chirgs is heading towards the region where Islamic State mortar attacks have been on the increase.
Wind tank empty.
Needed overhead for 6 hours to support coalition ground troops below. The Typhoons must first take on extra fuel in mid-air.
Air-to-air refueling is one of the most insane things.
Tankers coming left about.
Flying at 500 miles an hour, pulling up behind a massive tanker, plugging your probe into a basket the size of a dinner plate.
Monster 1-2, visual request join.
Monster 1-2, Bam Bam, you're clear, join.
Join, Monster 1-2.
The most dangerous thing you can do is look at the basket and make a last minute lunge for it. It's a game of patience.
Wind tank empty. Wind tank empty.
And all of this comes under the mounting pressure of running out of fuel. That's the time where you earn your money.
Not too bad. Day one.
Day one. Excited.
Yeah, absolute fast. Getting out of Aki. A critical bit of paperwork was missing. But hey, all good now.
We love a bit of paperwork fast, don't we?
Oh, yes.
Monster 2, complete on the left, request disconnect.
Monster 2, disconnect. Monster 2, you're clear to leave 1,000 below. See you guys in a bit.
See ya.
Rolling out.
It's a big moment, the first time you enter a war zone. This country that you've seen on the news so many times before growing up. All the people that have died there and all the, you know, conflicts and wars that's happened, and now you're in a fighter jet flying over it for the first time.
Oh my God. I don't know why I'm sweating so much, man. It's like whole body's just rigid.
In a hangar on the north side of the base, troops from across RAF Lossiemouth are preparing to be inspected by the SWO.
One more after this individual. It's all right, you're not the last one, and you're not late yet.
Under scrutiny is their ceremonial uniform, known as their number ones, ahead of Remembrance Day.
Most of them have never done a parade at unit level before, so the reality is they're probably a little bit unsighted on what the standard that they should be achieving is. So the detail that we need to focus in on, it's really important. This is just another facet of military discipline. Troops, can I just ask that you start giving yourselves the once over so that when we get through to the number one inspection, it's a fairly painless affair, okay? So just start helping one another out.
Have you got braces on?
No, and no, I don't.
Tallest on the right, shortest on the left, single rank size. Sabine?
Yep.
Griffiths?
I think the number one's inspection for everyone in the armed forces puts the feeler guard into them.
All right, what's going to happen then this morning is you're going to have your number one inspection. That will include your shoes. So if there's anything I need you to work on over the next couple of days, then please take that on board and make sure it happens. What I don't expect to happen is we get to Sunday morning and I'm coming back down here and picking people up because Sunday is go, no go. All right?
I will not let them go on parade if their standards are below where they should be.
You on Movember, yeah?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, all right, well...
I'm trying my best.
You're trying your best. Well, you've got till Saturday. If it looks totally towed on Saturday, don't be parading looking like a wally. How long we had you for at Lossie?
3 weeks.
3 weeks, all right, no dramas at all. Fresh out the wrapper. Happy to be here?
Yep.
Correct answer. Your belt is on back to front, all right? You need to pay attention. Have you got number one shoes? They're in Glasgow. That's not great. They're gonna need a bit more work, aren't they? So Sunday, you're gonna be number one on my list for inspection. Step over. That rings a bell. That's not what we want, is it? You just fall yourself out. Right, if anybody's got mobile phones on them, take the opportunity to fall yourself out and put your mobile phone over there. What I don't want to be doing is making my way down the line and people's phones are ringing, because it upsets me. Go on in. Troops, you need to start tuning in on this now. This is a parade practice, so in essence, a parade. You would not parade with mobile phones in your pockets, all right? So let's start tuning in. Have you got braces on?
No, I don't.
You don't, right, you need braces on with uniform. The reason why you need braces on is because that's why you end up with a big flump at the bottom there, all right? So braces on, please, for Sunday. Just have a look, right. This is what I was meaning. So he's got braces on, he's got them set right, and the way that they sit on the shoe, that's how it needs to be, all right?
Yeah.
So that's what I expect from yourself on Sunday. Okay. So there's a little bit more work to do there for certain areas. You know, those individuals that have been asked to improve areas, I'll obviously be targeting in on you on Remembrance Morning, okay? The reality is we've got an opportunity to represent the Royal Air Force on Sunday for Remembrance. And that is something that we should be exceptionally proud of, and no doubt that your friends and your families will also be exceptionally proud of. Does everybody understand that? All right. They're my eyes and ears. If you're not hitting the timings and your attitude doesn't reflect, then obviously you get to come and have a conversation with me, which nobody particularly wants to have. Don't make it harder than it needs to be.
For me, Remembrance is hugely significant. It's the one time in the year where we can all come together as a nation and, you know, we can all show our respects together.
By the centre, quick, march, left, 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 right, left.
Have you lost anyone close to you?
Oh, yes. They were both good guys. They'd done multiple tours in theatre. And, unfortunately, they didn't come home.
This is not just all about the parade. The day itself is about remembering. When it's that 2 minute silence after the last post, just think about who they are, what they are, what they're part of, and our forebears, you know, that did give that ultimate sacrifice. So yeah, that's certainly what I'm hoping for. If that doesn't happen, then they'll be hell on. Do you know what I mean? They'll be back at it for weeks.
Typhoon pilot Chirks is flying over a war zone for the first time.
Are you tracking the latest frog strike? Yeah, we've got the up.
I wanted to be a pilot ever since I was about 3 or 4. But I like to mess around a lot and
dick about in school.
750, copy, check in.
Chief Savage 180.
And to be a fighter pilot, you need to pass the aptitude test. 6 to 8 hour grilling on everything from your verbal reasoning to your, you know, your maths ability. It's just your ability to multitask.
Chief Savage 1561.
I failed the aptitude test on 3 occasions. Which was really depressing, frustrating, just being told no. Failing 3 times in a row, that haunts me quite often. And sometimes I feel like I'm an idiot, I'm an imposter.
Bad monster, see mortar fire, point of impact was to our south.
Coalition troops on the ground have radioed Chirgs after being targeted by a mortar.
Can you confirm this point of origin of the mortar fire? The point of origin was about 5 nautical miles to our southwest. Copy.
The second you get near, it's a case of bringing out the camera, all your sensors, trying to look for that mortar position.
Equipped with a long-range infrared camera, Chirgs can monitor Islamic State suspects from over 5 miles above.
I'm eyes on. Like a single truck.
Just in the middle of a big field.
There's a monster. Eyes on a single truck. It's orientated northwest, southeast. So there's a bunch of objects just to the south. Six in a circle and like a long rectangular object in the middle of it. Just request you maintain eyes on that truck. Can you ID any of the objects in that kind of circle just to the south of it?
I'm about to pass over the top, so we'll get a better look. Those circles are holes in the ground.
Copy.
In the back of the vehicle, it looks like multiple barrels and boxes, but it's hard to tell. See this guy walking around the vehicle?
Copy.
Overhead of the target,
I'm visual one individual walking around the vehicle. Maintain eyes
on that person. Dropping a bomb, it's the most serious thing we do. But ultimately, I've got a decision to make. Am I gonna have to take him out?
Typhoon pilot Chirgs is monitoring a suspected Islamic State militant.
What is this guy doing? What are those holes in the ground? Is he setting up to fire another mortar? Is he getting ready for another attack?
These are all thoughts that are rushing through your mind, and at the same time, you're trying not to force yourself into seeing something that's not actually there.
Looks like he's got loads of bags of something. Like concrete bags.
My biggest concern is that he's just set up a new mortar position and now he's heading home where he can detonate it remotely. I've got a decision to make. Either he's going to kill our troops or we're going to have to take him out.
It's a big deal. Your heart is racing.
you are ready to potentially kill someone.
Can you ID any of the objects?
All of a sudden, I see the ground starting to move.
I can't quite make it out. I'm wondering if they're sheep.
I think that large rectangular thing of the vehicle is a trough.
Yeah, copy, that would make sense.
Quickly, it all starts to make sense that this individual is most likely a farmer.
You guys got any more tasking for us?
Negative, nothing additional at this time. Oh, hey, we appreciate the help, though, and I hope you guys have a safe flight.
Anytime, man, just give us a shout. Have a nice day.
It was good flying back that day, feeling relief.
Knowing that an innocent person didn't lose his life.
We came really close, but we made the right choice.
Call 1-1, clear to land. The overrun cable up and barrier unset.
Thanks.
His first mission is over. But Churg still faces another 16 weeks of operations before returning to RAF Lossiemouth.
It is crazy to think I've gone from joking around at school to now being involved in a war against one of the most deadly terror groups in the world.
You need to be confident in your own abilities. If you drop a bomb in the wrong area, there are going to be repercussions that, you know, could affect the entire world.
We've got low pressure between Iceland and Norway. That's really dominating our weather for the next couple of days.
Morning. How are you this morning? Living the dream, thank you. Nice sunrise this morning. You don't get these anywhere else in the RAF, you see. You only get them at Lossiemouth. The joys, the glamorous role. That's what, five vehicles there that should have been gone this morning. And if the individuals are on the station and have just ignored the direction that was given, then obviously we'll have a conversation then.
You driving?
Yeah, I'll drive.
Sure. At least it's not raining and sideways wind, mate.
It's not freezing, though.
Just one side flew from Lossiemouth, and it's only a two-hour tack or two.
The lights of what you get in the cockpit. There's no point risking it on how many pee bags you want to take. The last thing you want is to be one short. And the trick is always to have something to put them into afterwards. The domestic living in a cockpit is a humbling part of being a fighter pilot. Only when you've sat in your own pee for about 2 hours over Mosul have you really made it. It's what you don't see on Top Gun.
Happy. Yeah, mate. Happy days.
I once slept in the same bed as Prince William.
Whoa!
A friend of mine hosted William at his house and had stayed in his spare room, and since then it was known as the Royal Room. And I stayed round at this mate's place one time and, of course, was in the spare room. It's like, well, you've got the Royal Room, so...
Nice.
Yeah, you know, shared the same bed as Prince William. Not at the same time. My name is Zane Sennett. I'm a squadron leader. I've been flying in the military for just over 25 years now.
As a former Red Arrow and veteran of four tours of Afghanistan, Zane is one of the most experienced pilots at RAF Lossiemouth.
It's demanding, particularly at the moment. There's a lot going on.
the invasion of Ukraine has caused the whole stability of Europe, and one could argue the whole wider world, to be thrown open. If things were to escalate, or if any situation escalates where I'm being called upon to drop weapons in defense of those troops that you are directly in support of, you need to be all over it. Your execution needs to be flawless and perfect.
As a squadron leader, Zane must prepare junior pilots in case the UK is pulled into the conflict.
OK, 0730 Zulu. Our aim, safe, effective and timely air-to-surface attacks. Added on to that, exciting times for you, your first live kinetic drop. How are you feeling about it?
Yeah, excited, slightly nervous, but we're going to go out and do what we have practiced to do with dry weapons and, yeah, excited. My name is Matt and I'm a pilot on the Typhoon Force on 6th Squadron at Barre Flossymouth. It's a big deal for me on a personal level today. Something that I've been training for a long time.
It is live weaponry, you know. However, nothing changes on that. All the checks, balances, rules, procedures that were snapped to remain the same. But just cognizant, it's your first time that you're going to release something live from the jet. Target is Cape Wrath, Garvey Island.
Matt's mission is to fly 90 miles northwest to Cape Wrath, where all Lossiemouth pilots must master precision bombing.
Once you've done it, you know, the picture paints 1,000 words. So, OK, with that, any other further questions?
No questions.
We'll crack on.
Matt qualified as a Typhoon pilot shortly after Russia invaded Ukraine.
The recent invasion of Ukraine is not only upsetting, but something that's scary to see. I've not seen something of this scale, and certainly it's the closest that Europe has ever been to being at war with Russia, and something that could just be around the corner.
You guys still got 3 grains.
It was a big step to sign up. It was unknown territory for me and for my family and friends.
Yeah, that should be fine. Brakes on.
I don't come from a military background at all. My family were, especially my mum, slightly nervous about some of the things that we would potentially be asked to do in a war zone on operations. But it's something that they have come to terms with. I think that there is a bigger picture. It's scary, but it's something that I need to be ready to go and do.
Copied. Taxi by Alpha 22 Echo.
It's quite difficult to mentally prepare yourself to employ a weapon for the first time.
Enter runway 28 and Alpha 2, expect backtrack.
I can still remember, and I'm sure it'll be the same, the adrenaline, and he will feel a certain amount of anxiety.
Venom 1, 1 flight clear to take off, Destin 21007.
Clear to take off, Venom.
But it needs to happen. We need to bring on our young people to eventually conduct operations.
Passing approach, Venom 11, flight of 2, airborne, 11, passing high 1,100 feet traffic service.
It's nerve-wracking, but I need to be able to drop those bombs. I hope that I have what it takes.
Parts of northwest Scotland have been used by the military as a firing range for over a century.
Sonic Mill, Venom 11, flight of 2, climbing flight level 240, traffic service.
attempting to drop his very first live bomb, is fighter pilot Matt.
Pod is in. Request to talk on, please.
But first, he must ensure the targeting system is working correctly.
Pushing primary, Venom.
It's part of the training process for us being ready for operations.
2 at 5,500 feet, visual.
There is a huge element of trust within yourself. What we're being asked to go and do is massive.
I have the large white house with the buildings or barn buildings to the west.
We need to be ready to hit anything from a static target to a moving vehicle.
10 yards approximately to the east is a single vehicle. It's on the northern end of a circular, what appears to be driveway.
This will start with ensuring the laser ranging is completed.
That's copy. It looks like a small family vehicle.
It's a high-tech bit of kit, costs a lot of money, and it allows us from many thousands of feet up to precisely hit targets.
Laser crew, Venom 1-1, Venom 1-1, lasing
1532. Only once all systems have been checked can Matt move on to his target.
Final attack heading 200 degrees through 260 degrees true.
A 5 metre square on Cape Roth's Garvey Island.
Target Alpha Bravo.
Venom 1-1 is tally target.
Clean hot. Venom 1-2.
If Matt misses, he won't be allowed on overseas operations.
Venom at 1-2, 1 away, 30 seconds. Venom 1-2, 10 seconds.
Venom 1-1 shows direct hit, and that sort of complete.
Good job, buddy.
Thanks.
I'm looking to proceed now to the low-level release, if happy.
Copy.
The skill of low flying is very relevant at the moment. The current conduct of operations across Eastern Europe has, I think, brought low-level flying back to the fore of a relevant tactic for ingressing into enemy territory.
Venom 1-2, in hot, heading 2-4-6.
And one that the Typhoon Force needs to be practiced at.
Type 2, bomb and quarter, 1 times payway 4, instantaneous, ready, Casbury, Venom 1-1.
Flying at 450 miles per hour, just 1,000 feet off the ground, is how pilots practice low-level attacks.
Venom 1-1, ready, system reback.
The stakes are extremely high. If my task is to deliver a bomb in a particular area, perhaps at a particular time, something goes wrong and I drop that bomb in the wrong place, the responsibility of what you're about to deliver has got to be there. If you haven't done that, you've done the enemy's job for them.
Venom 1-1, 10 seconds.
Copy. Venom 1-1 from Turbo, that's a splash, a direct hit.
Venom 1-1, copy.
That's a direct hit, mission success, Grand Commanders in 10 men.
Venom 1-1, copy.
City with lofty mountain sub-4.
Within my lifetime, this is the closest Europe has been to war.
Thank you.
scary. Some of the things that we are asked to do, there's a lot of pressure involved within that. We are the people in the cockpit. We're the people pressing the button, and that's something that we need to come to terms with.
So as a station warrant officer, you're there to set the example. So as far as having the shiniest shoes, I'll always try my hardest to have those shiniest shoes. There's a whole cadre of warrant officers across the organisation, whether that's RAF, Army, Navy, that will judge you on the standards of your uniform. And actually, it's one of those that you don't want to let the badge down. You know, the big badge is it's the Royal Coat of Arms, so it's, you know, it's a big deal. So when you've got your uniform on, you should be rightly proud to wear it. But also, you've got to make sure that uniform is to the absolute best standard that it can be.
I've had quite a varied number of deployments.
Rob has served for 25 years as an RAF firefighter.
Served in Iraq, served in Afghanistan. 2010 was a particularly kinetic year, and you know what, we lost a lot of men and women that year. My two friends that lost their lives on operations, they were both operating in a particularly dangerous area of Afghanistan, and they did so, you know, in service of their country on operations. They've helped me out no end when I've been working in that forward location. You know, I'll always remember that. There is no time scale on how that affects different people. Doesn't matter if you were in the Second World War, or, you know, whether it was Kosovo, Bosnia, First Gulf War, Second Afghanistan. There is that minute silence where the hairs in the back of your neck stand up.
Are you ready for my inspection then? Wait, you got belt faff, have you? Take your blue belt off and put your ceremonial belt on.
Sir.
How are you, bud? Tash is coming on nice, isn't it, now?
Yeah, it's great.
How are you, Sarge?
Good, thank you, sir.
You need to get shorter, I tell you. Intimidating me, being so tall. Right, I'm going to pick the spider that's off your neck. Can you feel it the whole time? There we go. Well done you for not moving, though. Yeah, you're right with that belt as well. All right, good effort, well done. All right, listen, troops, good effort this morning so far. Start putting the game face on now, all right? Good luck, enjoy it. You should be exceptionally proud, A, of the effort that you've put in, but B, of how you turned out this morning. Represent not just Royal Air Force Lossiemouth, but the Royal Air Force as a whole as well.
The sun
and in the morning, we will remember them.
They were outstanding in the way that they delivered that parade in front of thousands of people in the community. Paying our respects for the ultimate sacrifice that's been made by those that went before us. It just hammers home exactly what we're in the business of. And the importance of what we do. We have a different way of engaging with death to most people, and we know what it is to take a life. And we know about losing people in that way. It can be difficult sometimes, but you know, when it comes to it and they go out the door in operations, they do it in the defence of our nation.